Welcome to Inland Empire Live on the IEMG, Inland Empire Media Group. I'm Dennis Baxter. We are celebrating 200 years of the city of San Bernardino. And of course, celebrating the bicentennial also includes musica, musica, musica. Some fantastic music from our very own San Bernardino Symphony. And joining me live on the program right now, the one and only Carlotta Mellon and Earlene Ferguson Dudley, bicentennial representatives for Celebrate America Symphony. Ladies, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. Let's talk,
pleasure,
Carlotta, a little bit about your involvement in the Bicentennial Committee and how the symphony has dovetailed into this whole event.
As we planned our 2009-10 season, we were very much aware of the city's bicentennial and wanted to do something special to salute the city. They've been tremendous supporters of the arts, and art should be an integral part of any celebration for a city, any big event. So we came up, or at least our conductor did, and we all bought into it, with Celebrate America, an all-American program of music to salute the city's bicentennial.
And of course, we have to mention the conductors, the one and only Carlo Ponte.
Right.
Who has been just a wonderful, wonderful conductor for the symphony. How many years now?
He's in his ninth season, and next year is a very special year celebrating his 10th anniversary.
That's fantastic. We are celebrating our bicentennial, 200 years, the city of San Bernardino. And what will this year's program entail?
Well, for our concert on May 1st, which is our
coming
celebration and coming up soon, so people really need to get tickets right away.
Right.
The American program begins with Leonard Bernstein's Overture to West Side Story, Samuel Barber's Violin Concerto, with our soloist Edwin Huizinga, who's from Vancouver and a fine young violinist, and we conclude with Aaron Copland's magnificent Third Symphony.
And of course, it'll be at the California Theater once again, correct?
Correct. Why in the city's most wonderful historic theater.
That's right, built in 1928. Mm-hmm. Earlene, share with us how the Bicentennial Parade and the symphony are going to be working in concert together, if I may so use the term.
Well, when the request went out that they were seeking entrance for the parade, I thought, well, this would be a great way for the symphony to make itself aware to some patrons that are potential patrons that we don't
right.
have yet.
Right.
So we decided, you know, and I'm always the first one to want to decorate something. So
good.
So we're going to do that. I'm looking forward to it. We have a good committee that's going to help us put it together, and you know, from carpenters to
so this is a float. Is this
we're
a float?
Yeah. I'm sorry. Yes, we are going to do a
oh,
float.
Oh, okay, great.
Yeah, and I'm real excited about getting involved in that for the parade.
Can you share at all what the float will look like, or is that top secret?
Right. Well, it's kind of top secret right now because we're still in the planning stages, but we're looking forward to it.
And we'll be talking about the Bicentennial Parade, of course, on another one of these Inland Empire Lives that you'll see here on IEMG.
Yes.
But it's so wonderful the symphony is going to be involved in that.
Yes.
Absolutely.
And we're also going to have this a pre-concert dinner on May 1st at 5 p.m., and it'll be in the California Room upstairs on the second floor of the theater, California Theater. And we have local restaurants who are going to be participating with a wonderful, we're going to do a Mexican-themed restaurant to kind of tie in with Cinco de Mayo, which is just a few days later,
mm-hmm.
And also to recognize our great Hispanic heritage in this area as well.
You know, Arlene, talk about heritage. The San Bernardino Symphony, of course, started in 1929 by Maestro James K. Guthrie, who was also an internationally renowned conductor and community leader. Talk a little bit, either one of you, about the history of the symphony and where it has come from over the last, well, certainly since 1929.
Mr. Guthrie was quite young when he started as a professional musician. I think he was in his mid-teens. And he worked very hard to establish the symphony. And over the years, we've had a number of conductors, all high quality people, but we're so thrilled that we've got Maestro Ponte with us now. He's continued on the tradition of having a wonderful orchestra and producing just the finest music, classical music you can hear anywhere.
Well, you know, we talked a little bit about this event, Carlotta. It's coming up very quickly.
Yes.
It's coming up May the 1st, California Theater. That's a Saturday, and people need to actually get their tickets right now. How can they acquire tickets?
They can do it online at www.sanbernardinosymphony.org.
Good.
They can also purchase it at the California Theater. They can phone 909-381-5388 or go to our office at 415 West 2nd Street, and we would welcome them. It's just going to be a fabulous concert, and we have such fine musicians. When Mr. Guthrie started, it was not a professional orchestra, and it is a professional orchestra with some of the finest musicians who play throughout Southern California.
It has a sound all to its own and makes us extremely proud, especially to be heard with the acoustics of the California Theater. So call now to get those tickets. And by the way, I understand this performance is being dedicated the Centennial of San Bernardino Community Hospital, as well as our own 200 years in the city. Share with us how that all came about.
We knew that it was the centennial for the hospital, and it's half the age of the city, and we thought, why not have a double celebration? Bicentennial, have two celebrations, that of the city's bicentennial and the community hospital centennial. It's been a wonderful, integral part of this community, serving the people for 100 years, so we wanted to recognize the community hospital as well.
I think that's a wonderful idea, and of course, I was born at San Bernardino Community Hospital. When it was over on Arrowhead prior to its move over to Medical Center Drive. So, yeah, I am that old. But it's just a wonderful celebration that you folks have really, really gotten involved in here, both the city as well as community hospitals 100 years and the 200 years of the city. Tell us a little bit more about this performance. I know it's Americana, it's Aaron Copland, it's Carlo Ponte, but let's really entice people as to why they need to participate, especially right now.
Well, this is a program that Maestro Ponte designed himself as a special salute to the city. Bernstein's a wonderful composer. He's well-loved, and West Side Story is just a great piece, and I think it's a wonderful work to do. The Barber Violin Concerto is less often played. It's a very challenging piece. It's also the 100th anniversary of Barber's birth, so it's an important time to commemorate.
Ah.
And then Copland is one of America's finest conductors, and the Third Symphony is his monumental work. It's one of his best known. It's not always played as often as some of his others. So I think people will be in for a real treat. What I think it attests to as well is the quality of this orchestra. Under Maestro Ponte, we've done Mahler's Fifth Symphony.
Right.
We're doing Copland's Third. This is terrific, world-class symphonic music right here in our own backyards. You don't have to drive an hour or more into LA or Orange County. The people
you
of San Bernardino.
You don't have to even pay to park.
No, it's wonderful parking, and it's just a great, as you said, the acoustics are wonderful in the theater. People come with their friends, and it's a great evening out, as well as just terrific entertainment.
And indeed it is some of the finest entertainment you can find in Southern California in the beautiful California Theater. Carlotta, what is on tap for the remainder of the year? You have this fantastic event, but what else is going on in 2010 with the symphony?
Well, for this season we're ending, but beginning October 9th, we have our new season, which will be Beethoven's Seventh, which is the first piece that Maestro Ponte played when he joined our symphony. So it's going to be a wonderful opening celebration, and we've got a terrific lineup. Again, people can find both season tickets for the new season as well as tickets for the May 1 concert and pre-concert dinner on our website, www.sanbernardinosymphony.org, or call 909-381-5388, and seating at the dinner is very limited. You can come to both the dinner and the concert, or one, or just the concert.
And Earlene, you'd advise people to get out and see the parade, because you guys have a mystery float that is going to be participating in our bicentennial parade, which I think is extremely exciting.
We're
I want to thank both you ladies for coming on the show today and sharing with us how the symphony is playing such an integral part, not just in the rich past of our history, but also the bright future of the city of San Bernardino. Carlotta Mellon, Earlene Ferguson Dudley, thank you so much for being on
the program. Thank you for having us on.
Call today to get those tickets and be a part of San Bernardino's wonderful symphony experience. Stay tuned to IEMG, because you never know, upcoming there'll be other programs dedicated specifically to our own bicentennial. I'm Dennis Baxter. Good to be with you.